make one more video because this has been on my mind. And it's an ongoing theme of like my conversations with my friends over the past couple of weeks. So, ladies and gentlemen, mainly ladies, because I realize that y'all are 74% of my following, and I think that is so cool. Oftentimes, once we're locked in and like we're moving in purpose, we're focused, we're driven, what do? We start finding ourselves a love interest, or we attract one. We don't necessarily go looking. I know that from what I've observed, I think we shine brighter, we're happier, we're more outgoing. And so that will attract people, guys or potential mates, not just guys, to you. Or friends too. And I want to talk about distractions. I want to talk about how on our journeys, we pray, we work, we hope, we dream for things, and when said things comes into our life, we don't capitalize on those opportunities because we get lost in our distractions. And one of the biggest distractions that have come up in my life is love interest and guys in particular, for the most part. It could be other relationships as well, but I want to focus on that. So ladies, if you are out here shining bright, you glowing up, expect men or women or whatever you're into to be attracted to you. And try to have a contingency plan or a plan of like how you're going to handle that. For me, the plan is having standards. You know, I have taken the time to learn what I need in a partner. And so while I'm not looking to date, I am open to someone that attracts me on that level, and I'm, as they're courting me, I'm figuring out, do they have like what I need in a partner? And some of those things are like effective communication, emotional availability, no longer stuck on an ex, an interest in what I'm doing and his own goals. I don't care if he's like trying to be the best garbage man in America. He has to have his own goals. He has to be in a place of holding himself accountable, because guess what? You get this hardworking girlfriend, potential wife, and she's just out here shining and glowing and growing. And here you come with your funk, or your lack of focus and your distractions and your drama, and it pulls her down. That, or she keeps progressing and you feel like she's neglecting you and this and that because you don't understand the commitment and the sacrifices that comes with being goal-oriented or purposeful. So that's why I have to have some of those standards built in. And if I'm interested in someone and they prove to not have those skills, cool, nothing against him, but I have to keep it pushing. Because what will happen is like I'll give that individual my energy, and that takes away from like what I'm called to do. And I'm not willing to sacrifice that anymore. I'm not willing to force any more relationships. I'm good, girl. So this all to say, if all of a sudden you start feeling all of this sexual desire or this need for male attention, or just like, oh my goodness, such and such is interested, know that that is a part of the journey. Know that you have to stay true to you. And there may be times where you're like, nope, I'm good. And I support you in that. And there may be times of like, you know what, I really want to get to know him. I feel like there's something special. And I support you in that. And it might be times where you're like, you know what, I'm doing good. I deserve some vitamin D. And I guess I support you in that as well. As long as you understand that when you lay down with someone, you're giving just as much as you're taking. So if you are just focused on like this intense amount of physical pleasure, you're still giving your energy. You're still hormonally bonding with this person, whether you logically want to. You're still giving time. This is time that you could be resting. This is time you could be working out. This is time you could be investing in your business or your audience or whatever. You're giving. You're giving a lot. When you daydream about this person in a brain that normally wouldn't have them built in, you're giving. So even if it's just about a vitamin D thing, honey, you are giving. Give an energy that you could be storing up for something better. Give an energy that if you pride yourself in being a queen, there will be a standard for you to give. Even if it's not sex, even if it's just having companionship and someone to talk to. If you are a queen, your time is valuable. Your energy is valuable. And not anybody should be able to walk up, knock on your door, and walk in. Period. That's where I'm at. It's really hard to implement sometimes, but the more you carry that in your heart, your mind can have it, but in your heart, the easier it is to like filter through these people, these guys, these opportunities, and get what you deserve and walk away not distracted but supported, not neglected but loved and appreciated. And I mean, if you this amazing person trying to change the world in however way you can, you deserve that. You deserve that type of love.